Hi, Luke from Korg here at Nevada. I'm looking today at the PA300, a great new professional arranger product we've just brought out. So let's take a listen. Over to this side of the instrument, you've got this section called performance. So what the performances are basically setups of collections of instruments, which you can then add to the style or just play them by themselves. So if I go into different categories, you'll see here, so going to the strings category, you've got lots of presets here of like orchestral sounds, and some things like this kind of piano concerto type sound, where we've got a piano. And then lower down on the keyboard, we can bring in and out different instruments. So you can play kind of a whole instrument orchestration if you want to, with piano, orchestra, and you can see on the screen here how that's built up. So we've got a piano on part one, we've got an orchestral tutti sound, which is the one which reacts to the velocity, then some strings as well, and some more strings, so just to make it very rich. So here's another performance. This time I've got this orchestral sound called Imperial Orchestra, and I'm going to play it so you can hear what it sounds like. So it sounds like that. Again, very dynamic velocity switching going on there. If I want to record that, again, very simple. Hit sequencer and press record. Again, back in sequence, because all I want to do is capture what I'm doing instantly. Set it all up as I want. And I'm going to turn on the metronome this time, because I'm not going to have any drums playing. So there's my tempo. So all I have to do is press start. I'll give me one bar in again. So I've recorded my main part, and of course then I'm free to do stuff over the top of it and change the tempo. So that was a little bit slow for the original piece, so I'm just going to speed it up a little bit. So you get the idea. You can get your ideas down really quickly. Great for film composing as well. Any kind of songwriting, film composing as a scratch pad, just amazing. Okay. Of course, I can add my rhythm to that. But if I want to record that, it's a very simple process. All I have to do, go into sequencer, and then I can say, press record, and it gives me a choice. Do I want to do a multi-track sequence, so start from scratch, voice it myself, or I can select back in sequence, which is called quick record, which basically captures everything I was just doing and sets it up ready. So now it's waiting for me. I can, if I want to, set the resolution, which is the input quantize, to a note value, so I can quantize it to semiquavers, if I want to, or sixteenths, and now I'm ready to go. So all I have to do is hit start, and it'll give me one bar in, and I can record. It's now recorded. Great thing about this is it allows me to revoice it then if I want to. So I can go into, say, track one, which is my strings, and I can go and choose a different instrument. So say I wanted to have a synth sound, synth lead maybe, and I can listen to it while it's playing as well. So I can change sound. Now recorded. So once I've got that stage, I can save it if I want to. All I have to do is drop this down, press save song, save, give it a name, now I can exit this mode. I can go back into my main screen, press song play, load my song again. There it is. So this could be something that I've made or commercially available MIDI file. Then I've got this magic button here called lyrics and score, which means that I can then see anything that I've recorded on the screen as notation as well. So let's take a look at that. So I just press lyrics. If there's any lyrics in the file, it'll show them there. But if I press it again, it'll show me the score. I can select which track I want to see. And there it is. Choose the clef. And there's my notation instantly of what I've recorded. Of course, I'm showing both hands on one staff there because I'm showing track one. If I wanted to, I could have recorded them hands separately and seen them on separate staves quite easily as well. Okay. Back into style play, and just to finish off, we're going to do one more tune, again from my songbook. So again, it's brought in this, this is actually really good because it's a preset style called Orchestral Movie, which is in the style of Bond, basically. And I've got some one-touch settings here, so I've got stuff like my brass with some stabs, which is great for this kind of stuff. Stab down here. Or stuff like, of course, your main kind of theme. Or even this. Then we can bring the main pattern in. The style, using variation. Here we go. We'll be right back. there you go, PA300, go and try one. So PA300, very, very good keyboard for anyone really who wants to make music. Great styles in there, very versatile, all types of different genres, more than what I've just played in this demo. There's literally everything in there. Same thing for the sounds, and of course the portability of it, with the speakers built in as well, it makes it very portable. So on the screen, you can see that I can go into all the different styles. So everything, all the genres, from ballads, all the ballroom stuff, dance, rock. So each style has four variations, which you can select. There's an auto fill button as well, so you can automatically fill between those or not, if you wish. There's a break as well, so that should give you a bar breakdown. So you've got three intros, three endings. Intro one is a full-blown intro with usually quite a long intro in that particular style. Intro two is a similar thing, but you can actually, with your left hand, play whatever harmony you want for the song that you're going to play. And intro three is usually just a bar of counting. And the endings work in the same way. One is fully blown, two is you can chord it yourself, three is just a bar outro. Put your start stop button. You've got your synchro, so you can, if that's flashing on synchro start, that means it'll start when you play the chords. Or synchro stop, it'll stop, so it'll only play when you play. You can tap your tempo, which you saw earlier. You've got ensemble, so you can add harmony. Then you've got your performances. So these are settings for your favourite sounds or collections of sounds. And you've got this neat setting here called My Setting, which always puts the instrument back to zero. So anytime you just want to get back to your setting, by default that setting is just a single piano. So it's a nice neat way for anyone who's using it live or for presentations or anything, just quickly get out of jail free. There's my piano, no matter what's happening on the instrument. Got various other buttons here. You've got the pads that I showed you earlier, four pads for different loops or one shots. Turn on and off the accompaniment on the left side. Memory means that it will keep going when you take off your finger on the left. And manual bass means you can play manual bass lines rather than playing the accompaniment. These are your selection buttons. So the main selection being either selecting a style, a sound, a song setting, or a song itself. So that song can be in the internal memory, or it can be from a USB kit back. So that could be something that you've recorded, or a MIDI file, or an MP3 actually, it plays MP3s as well. This is where you set the tempo, you can find it as well. You can lock the tempo, which means even when you change style, that tempo will be the same, so that's great for auditioning different styles at the same tempo. Metronome built in. Your value dial with exit and menu takes you into all the main menus. Split is an important button because that's whether you're playing it as a whole keyboard, piano style, or split like a Ranger product, so melody on the right, chords on the left. Global transpose, very handy, and upper octave switch as well, so it's the power switch. Single touch settings, which we've looked at, and then you've just got your main mode, whether you're playing it in style mode, in song mode, so playing on the backing track or using it as a recording, and then you globally need it. Okay, so let's take a look at the back and the rear connections. So from right to left, as you look at it, you've got the power which is plugged in, then you've got the headphone output which also doubles up as an audio out, so it's a quarter inch stereo jack. Then you've got a pedal damper socket, so that can be used as a damper or a switch. And then you've got your two USB ports, so you've got your host one, which means you can plug in any USB key to save your data and also import MP3s and MIDI files and devices when you connect it to